Yes, what's up, High Flyers? And I wish you could smell the smell in here because it's lovely. We're all around us, we have this nice orange punch. Here we are on our road to Kanapamundi. We're almost there. The sun is out, Rome is treating us well. Fiat 500, more Italian it doesn't get. And let's go, baby, Kanapamundi, yes! So it's quite a funky place here, right? It looks quite modern. I'm expecting some nice companies that have very interesting grow material and some seeds or maybe even some CBD weed. Let's see what they have all around here. Probably good stuff because the Italians love quality. I think it won't be long and the weed will be known from Italy as well.
Buongiorno, Kanapamundi, hola, hey!
We're getting ready to fly high. Let's go inside. Kanapamundi, here we come. So we have arrived here and as you can see, it's a big, big professional fair. Lots of booths. It's looking clean, it's looking light, looking full of interesting stuff. Let's see what they have downstairs. Hey, buongiorno.
Hey, Chris. Hello. How are you?
Good, man. Good to see you. Yeah, man. So, I see you got here some really nice pots with interesting stuff inside.
Your new product is CBD weed. It's in collaboration with a partner from South Italy. We are growing different strains for try and select and also different CBD and low THC strain.
Yes.
And we have introduced this new product, our two varieties, that we are growing in a greenhouse with the supplement of the HPS labs.
Okay,
we
nice.
We are growing 10,000 plants every circle.
So that's a lot, guys. Fuck yeah, that's a good serious operation you got there.
Yeah.
And as you can see, in the past, CBD buds were not completely there yet because they were too close relative to the hemp plants. And now, because of the Dutch passion breeding for years and years, they have crossed this orange punch into the CBD flower. And I have to say, there are very interesting terps present in this little bud. It has some skinky stuff going on, combined with some orangey terps. It's actually very, very interesting little bud. Can you maybe tell me some about the difference between THC and CBD?
The things of CBD, you know, the effect, it's like a body effect. So it's not psychoactive.
Ah.
That's really interesting because a lot of people love smoke that during the day and don't feel stoned. So that's the particular thing of CBD. And now the quality is really high because the CBD market started in Italy 3 years ago.
Yeah.
You know, and grow really, really fast.
Yeah.
And now, but at the beginning was really hemp. So people started to sell flowers of hemp.
Hemp, yeah, right?
Like Carmagnola or some.
And people got upset, right?
Yeah,
this,
now we have a big brigade.
Yeah.
Also thanks to the breeding, you know, project that we did.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And now we have a flower that's the same of THC, the same terpenes profile.
Yeah.
But
this weed is like game-changing stuff. People will be able to enjoy cannabis, but without getting crazy in the head, you know? Who likes to smoke this? What kind of people?
Yeah, the main customers are like people between 30 years old and 50, 60.
50.
You know? Yeah, so people, adult people.
Yeah.
You know? And,
so let's say the responsible smoker is this is for them. Thanks a lot for the explanation. Fuck. Can I keep this?
Of course, man.
Yes, man. My Kanapamundi will be good now.
Yeah.
Thanks to Francesco. Hell yeah. See you, man.
See you.
Man. Score. Oh, look at this, guys. This is gonna be cool. This is something really Italian, I think. This is a vending machine with sweets, chewing gum, chocolate. They got cannabis apple juice. That must be the most healthy drink in this vending machine. So let's try it. Woo! Funky stuff, funky stuff. This is almost like apple syrup. Man was enjoying this funky apple juice. Take another little sip. Funky stuff, man. Who doesn't want to drink apple juice with cannabis, man? That's every smoker's dream. Look, they're making extracts at the moment now, so that's also quite unique on a fair. Most of the times, this is not allowed, of course. But because it's CBD, they can do this. So I think also the CBD is helping a lot, normalizing the cannabis. And as Francesco already said, like, the more older people and responsible people are getting into this, into the CBD, because they don't have the psychoactive effect. Look at it. He's upgrading the joint.
And right now we are getting rid of the last little bit of ethanol that we use to make our full spectrum extractions. We are the Jantec SLN.
Yes.
And we make everything from the cultivation of the hemp itself, the harvest.
it's almost crystallizing, right?
Yes, okay. It's because of the oxygen.
Look, it's crystallizing. This is crazy stuff.
It's
this is next level extract.
Pure CBD.
Yeah.
Okay.
Score, guys. Another score. Buongiorno. Buongiorno. Ciao.
Benvenuti.
This is Luca. And he makes crazy, crazy chilums.
Now we are ready to smoke.
Yes, let's do it.
Boom. Now we start a chilum.
Bon Shiva Shambo.
Bon Shiva.
Oh yes, that's the technique. Oh yes, look at that.
That's the proper way.
Grazie mille.
Grazie
mille. Ven aquí, ven aquí. Yeah. Good stuff. Yes. So hey guys, we're now going to check out this new stand. This is a stand of Seed Stockers. Seeds from Barcelona. This is a very nice new company with young people behind it, full of power, full of good energy. And they know what they're doing.
Hey man, how
good
you doing?
Yeah man, good to see you.
We are a seed company from Barcelona.
Yeah.
And we have a lot of selection of feminized and multi-flower seeds. And we've just had new varieties from California.
That's cool, that's super cool. Because you have to know now guys, where the good stuff comes from in the world, it's in Barcelona and it's in California. And they got the genetics, both of them. So they've got the good stuff.
My favorite strain is Santa Marta Hazel.
Nice.
I love haze tastes. And it takes long to the flower for the normal one, but the auto flower is the perfect combination.
Yeah. Great solution for the unexperienced grower or the professional grower. If you want to have a shorter flower time, but still enjoy haze terps, go for auto flower haze. Then you have the really good stuff. That was
thank
very nice
much.
For your explanation.
Ah, I have a present.
Hey, oh, hola. Hey, thanks
you.
Man, thanks. Another score, guys. Yeah. Putting it on. Orange cap. Seed Stockers. Yeah, man. Thanks, Rafa.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Bye.
Yeah, man.
See you.
So that's another score, guys. Hell yeah.
Hey man, hi Kees, how are you doing?
Yeah, very good. You too?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Fine. Yeah, I know that you have written a very cool book. This is actually 2.0 already.
Yeah.
And I would like to know more.
It's a complete guide about cannabis growing, indoor growing, basically. It's not about outdoor. I made it based on my experience and also talked to other friends. Yeah,
okay, cool.
Because we growers always share the knowledge.
Sure, no, yeah, right.
Book is interactive. It's something what is not very usual.
Nice.
So you can see the QR Color codes code. Here. Yeah, if you scan it.
That's handy, with extra information.
Yeah, exactly. So nice. I say it's like a book from Harry Potter movie. You know,
Harry
they open the book and everything was moving there.
Nice. It's really complete. It's from seed till harvest.
Exactly.
All you need to know, you know, and written in a understandable way, you know.
That's I think so. Yeah. And I can give you one for free.
Oh man,
maybe
awesome.
It will be useful for you. Maybe you will find some useful information there.
Probably yes.
And
probably.
There is one very important information there. Grow or die.
Oh fuck yeah, I will grow for sure.
Do that.
Thanks a lot.
Nice to see you. Yeah. Nice to see you.
Yes guys. Another score. Yoo-hoo! Oh wow, look at this guys. We're in Ruva de Puglia. We're getting ready for the next day. We're gonna start with some nice breakfast. We have planned to go to a very nice old pasticceria, and then afterwards we'll go to the seaside, check out the beautiful nature from Puglia, have a little smoke probably, and then at night we will have a very nice dinner that I will be preparing hopefully, and it's going to be special. Yes, somebody recommended me this place. I have to say, it looks really good and it smells really nice as well. A good start of the day. So it's like not only a traditional cake, it's also locally produced. And that's what we are looking for when we fly around the world. We just look for the best weed, but while we are looking for the best weed, we try to enjoy the best locally produced food. It's like a citrus spongy cake with lots of nuts. So what do you guys think? You think those the old Romans were weed smokers? Because they loved their wine, that's for sure. So who knows, they were already had discovered this special plant as well, because they've been all over the world conquering all these places. Probably they got influenced by other cultures as well. If you know, please let us know in the comments below and then we'll check it out.
Okay, let's have a little spliff at the seaside. Yeah, man.
Before you light up your joint, just take a couple of dry puffs. And if the taste comes true, then you know it's good weed. And if you know, and if you taste, it tastes good when you puff dry, and you light it, and the taste is gone, then it's not good. The idea is that the dry puff you take, you should have the same taste when it's burning. Then you know, then it's good. And with this one, luckily enough, the taste comes through. It's nice. Perfect daytime beach smoke. Like a bit uplifting. No indica is in there, so this is nice to get. Nice to be on the beach, be social, maybe have a little cocktail afterwards and do a little dance or something. You know? I would call this like social weed. This is social stuff. It was a nice little break. Get ready for the rest of the day. Buonasera, ragazzi. We had a nice little beach break, and now it's time for mangiare. And we're gonna eat at this nice place, Free State, outside. And we're gonna eat pizza di canapa, aka pizza with cannabis. And I'm very curious how they have made it, how they have infused the pizza. Hey, Angelo.
Hello, hi.
How are you? Good, man. Good. Very nice restaurant you have.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Come here with me. We make pizza.
Yeah, it's nice.
Canapa, eh?
Yeah, pizza di canapa.
Yeah. Take your jacket.
Angelo, how do I look? Nice kitchen you have.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Thank you, man. Yeah. Which kind you like?
Prosciutto e funghi.
Prosciutto e funghi?
That's my favorite.
So we start to eat?
Yes, please.
Together?
Yes, show me. Yeah.
Oh, I push the pasta.
Yes.
Okay, and then I start to open it.
Open it, okay.
Okay. Okay. And then we make it in this way.
That was fast.
Yeah.
Can I try?
You can try, yeah. Good job, man.
Thanks, guys. It feels nice, eh? Good
job. Good job. Okay. Maybe one also more time. Okay, I like parmigiana. Aubergine fry.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is first fried and then in the
pecorino oven. Romano and fresh basil and buffalo. Okay. Good, man.
Angelo, can you tell me something about this special dough? Because this is not normal dough. This has something special in there, right?
20% of canapa.
Okay.
I don't know, semi. How do you say semi?
Seeds
of canapa.
Yeah.
Canapa sativa.
Oh, yeah. Also.
And the rest is farina tipo 1. Almost integrale.
Okay. Okay. Nice.
Okay. And then we make it 3 days ago.
3 days ago, okay. Yeah. Your pizza looks nice, man.
Hey, I'm professional. I'm professional.
Oh, look at this.
Okay.
Fixed, nice.
Then you can open again, it maybe. Yeah. I keep for you. Oh,
thank you.
Perfect, okay. My friend. Perfect.
Yeah.
And the pizza now is start to cook into the right side.
Yeah. It's easier than it looks, guys. It's not.
It's good.
Oh, first pizza ever made. Pizza di canapa.
This is our beer. We made it from our grain. Tritordem is calling.
Yes, yes.
Okay?
Okay. It's locally produced.
Look.
Look at that. Salute.
Nothing. Salute.
Pizza, beer and wheat, that's the best combination. Look at this. You can taste in the dough that there is a slightly cannabis taste present there for sure. And it really lifts the pizza up. So guys, that was the finishing of my pizza di canapa. Tomorrow we're gonna visit this massive CBD farm that with the most plants I've ever seen in the real life. I think around the 10,000 plants, so that is quite a facility. But first we're gonna end the night with some locally produced beer, pizza and cannabis. Man, my night is going very well already. So let's see tomorrow. Let's see you tomorrow, guys. What's up, high flyers? Look at this. I'm in heaven. We are here at Farma Puglia in the south of Italy, and this is the biggest CBD farm I've ever seen. This, the plants smell amazing, crazy nice orange punch, and I have to say, with this smell I could sleep in there without a problem. Also, the greenhouse here is the most professional I've ever seen. They've thought about everything, they've got the professional lights, they got closing tarps, they got special airflow machines. It's amazing, guys, really next level stuff. Yeah, around me are here are like the Colorado cookies and some of the orange punch. And I have to say, the plants are very happy, looking very healthy. This is still the vegetative grow room. So here the plants are being prepared for getting their last journey to the flowering greenhouse. And as you can see here, the plants are really nice, nicely topped. So they've got more branches, so they will produce more. And as you can see, the guys down there are working hard. So this is an impressive table, I have to say. On this table are like 1,400 plants, so that's quite a lot. And yeah, as you can see, very happy, very healthy, very branchy. What's also cool about this greenhouse, when it's outdoor the time of flowering, then they, well, let's say that the days are shorter than 12 hours or 12 hours of light, then these plants would flower, and that's what they don't want. So what they then do is put on, when the lights get dark, they put on the lights so there is more light, so they keep on vegging, or they close the shade to make sure not enough, not too much light comes in, that they also start flowering. So this is like a fully automatically nice greenhouse to make sure all these CBD plants are stay in the vegging state. So this is very cool. And this is all Dutch passion strains. And what they've did with these strains, like, they had a hemp, a little bit of CBD hemp strains, and then they crossed it with their orange punch. And what you do when you cross this the first time, the levels of THC and CBD will not be in the right values that the plant is legal. And what how they reach this is by breeding, you know. By breeding they can make sure that the CBD levels stay high and the THC level goes down. After 8 generations of inbreeding, you can say the CBD level is stable at 10 to 12%. And the THC levels are below the 0.3. And then, when this is the case, all the weed that's produced from these plants can be sold legally almost around the world, or let's say Europe and some parts in America as well. Buongiorno, ragazzi. All good? Working hard, eh?
Yeah.
The lollipopping, that's very important. A big difference from growing professionally and from growing in a nice little tent as a little freak. Like, as you can see, this is a massive amount of plants. This is so many plants that it's almost impossible to give each plant its own attention, let's say, or its own little moment of love and tenderness. When one plant has a disease, it's of course very exaggerated to treat all the plants with heavy pesticides or anything. So don't panic, it's organic. What you can do is take that plant out, make sure the other plants are still happy, and then you're good to go. And how you can recognize this is the pistils has turned brown already. This is only in the last 2 weeks, maybe in the last 3 weeks, it's that the pistils will start turning brown. What also is a nice sign from this, you can see the trichomes. This is the white shiny stuff. This is actually what it's all about. Inside of the trichomes are all the cannabinoids, the flavonoids, the flavors, the terpenes. Everything is in the trichomes. So as you can see, this plant is almost ready for harvest. And I just can't stop smelling this lovely pungent orange punch, man. It's so nice, really. We are harvesting now, and this is not harvesting your little tent from a freak or something. This is professional stuff. We are harvesting 2,000 plants here, guys. This is next level. What a good life. Living the good life, guys. Flying high. Hell yeah. We are here with Maximo and Claudio, the professional agronomist from Farma Puglia. Claudio, what are you going to do with all these flowers?
L'obiettivo aziendale è quello, come puoi ben vedere, di produrre un fiore di alta qualità con basso contenuto in THC cioè sotto allo 0,2 e massimo livello di CBD.
It's high quality stuff, organically grown, very nice. Can you also, so when the flowers are used, you have a lot of this green material. I think you call it biomass, right? Maybe Maximo, you can tell me more about what's biomass.
Sì, allora tutto quello che non viene messo nei vasetti, cioè tutto quello che non è fiore, insomma, viene reso biomassa. È estratto tutto, è ottenuto tutto naturalmente con metodi meccanici, quindi non troveremo sostanze chimiche o all'interno, né tossiche né dannose. Si può utilizzare per fini alimentari o anche farmaceutici, arrivando addirittura all'estrazione di olio di CBD o quant'altro.
Maximo, thank you for the very handy information. I liked it a lot. Claudio, also very good. These guys are rocking, guys. Keep on growing. Woo! Happy place. So here we are in my favorite room of the whole facility. As you can see, this is a live plant. You see, the leaves are still quite standing up and are happy. And we just relaxed, hang it upside down here. We don't have hurry, we don't have stress. We just let it hang for 2 weeks. Let it cure naturally and relax. It's also in a fridge. So what is also very cool about this, they can control the humidity and the temperature. If you, for example, won't store and cure your plants inside a room where you can't regulate the temperature, it can happen that the temperature becomes a bit high. And you can say like from 17 to 20 degrees, the temperature is too high and certain terpenes and flavonoids will start evaporating. And that's what you don't want, because that has the medicinal benefits. We just hang it here, put it on the rope, let it hang for 2 weeks. And after 2 weeks, we come back to trim the big leaves off and trim the buds off. This plant is still full of water. And in the drying process, the water will evaporate, of course. But the moment when you dry it, it loses almost 70% of its moist weight. Just an example, 100 grams. When it's dried, you'll be left with 30 grams. But 30 grams of high quality CBD. Good stuff, guys. My personal favorite part of the whole growing process, it's actually the after grow. And I've got like a next level trimming machine, whole conveyor belt system going on here. The dream of every grower, this kind of stuff. So let's have a look. And what they do is they separate the buds from the stems. And as you can see, it still contains quite some leaves. That's a lot of weed, guys. Yes, that's how we like to see our conveyor belts. With the final product, Pharmapuglia CBD weed, ready for you to enjoy. Oh man, this smells so good. So what's up, high flyers? It's the end of a beautiful day. We've been in Pharmapuglia all day, seeing this plant, checking it out. We've seen from plant to product. It was amazing, beautiful smells. Now we are concluding it. We have for sure more adventures for you in the future. If you like what we are doing, please subscribe, like, and push the bell. And if you maybe have ideas for us where we should visit for other adventures, please let us know. Probably we will go and we'll be flying high to the sky, guys. See you later. I love you.